foundation exercises I've been doing. So you need a block or ball. Coming onto all fours. So you're going to inhale to prepare, lengthen spine. Exhale, slowly lengthen your exhale, engage pelvic floor. A tiny little tuck of tailbone. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, so we're blowing out candles, so really slowly engaging. Breathing out. Tiny tuck at the end. So it's more about pelvic floor and core connection than tuck. Coming onto your side, we've got our clams. Feet in line with hips. Make sure hips are really stable. I'm just squeezing heels open and closing. And then you can lift the heels. Make sure you maintain pelvic floor core connection with this. Finish with some pulses and want to keep hips really stable. And roll onto our back. If you're in your second or third trimester, doesn't feel comfortable rolling your back, then skip this, but we're coming straight up using this block. And then come up, engage pelvic floor and lower down. One vertebrae at a time. Keeping front ribs down. Lifting up, squeezing. So rolling through. Box just there to remind us to engage. Then we're going to come into some pulses. Rolling down. Rolling up. And then grabbing a chair. So coming into some squats, you can use the block again. Feet together, pelvis really slow and controlled. Think about squeezing, hugging everything in. Engaging pelvic floor, so that block's a reminder. And holding here, just moving the block. I'm just going to slide this leg back, but keep really, really, really stable. So really slow and controlled. Shoulders down, ribs down. You can hold it out there and pulse. You can turn it out to the side a little bit if you like. That doesn't hurt your pubic bone. The focus is on stability, so think about hugging everything in, moving really slowly, just noticing any imbalance between the sides. And then of course your pelvic floor engagement, contractions, long slow holds, fast peaks, power. Okay, that's it from me.